station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Sandra Jones. This week, we celebrate the 20th anniversary of the Expedition 1 launch. All the while, the science continues on this space station as we learn about how the microgravity environment of this space station affects the human body. On October 31st, 2000, NASA astronaut and commander of the Expedition 1 crew, William Shepard, and his Russian crewmates, Sergei Krikalev and Yuri Gidzenko, launched to the International Space Station, officially beginning the continuous presence of humans living off the planet. Shepard reflected about his historic mission with NASA's Gary Jordan on the latest edition of Houston, We Have a Podcast.
If we're going to go past the moon, out to Mars and maybe other places, asteroids and things like that, the character of how we will do this is going to have several aspects. And they're going to have to combine the resources of more than just one country, because the expense of a Mars mission is not something any single country is going to be able to afford, nor would they have all the technology and capability that will be required. And so if you look at International Space Station, it's really a blueprint for how to do this.
You can hear the entire interview with Commander Shepard right now or anytime. Houston, We Have a Podcast is available on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, SoundCloud, or nasa.gov/podcast. In the 20 years that have followed, 241 people from 19 countries have lived and worked aboard the International Space Station, completing almost 3,000 science experiments. And that science continues. NASA astronaut Kate Rubins took part in a study to determine to what extent an astronaut's ability to visually interpret motion, orientation, and distance may be disrupted in a microgravity environment, and how it may be changed upon return to Earth, as part of the effect of long-duration hypogravity on the perception of self-motion study. Back on Earth, NASA's SpaceX Crew-1 mission has a new target launch date. NASA astronauts Michael Hopkins, Victor Glover, and Shannon Walker, along with Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency mission specialist Soichi Noguchi, are now scheduled to launch at 7:49 p.m. Eastern Time on Saturday, November 14th, from Launch Complex 39A at Kennedy. NASA will provide continuous coverage until they are welcomed aboard the International Space Station as Expedition 64 crewmates, where they will spend 6 months conducting research, maintenance, and spacewalks. Visit nasa.gov/commercialcrew for the latest information on Crew 1. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag AskNASA. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.